Avza Kavakçakan. She's a member of parliament for Turkey's ruling party as well as a political analyst, and she's in Istanbul. Thank you so much for your time this Sunday. You know, just looking at that story, when that coup happened, how did life change, especially for those wanting to openly practice their faith in Turkey?
Yashni, this was something done against people who wanted to exist in the Turkish society with their own identities. It could be their religious identity, ethnic identity, but the system, the regime at that time couldn't tolerate whatever didn't fit the ideal citizen definition that it had created. Whatever was compatible, it couldn't exist. So the people who faced the most level of discrimination were the women who wear the headscarves. They were on the streets, they were attacked. There was an understanding that they posed a threat to the nature of the state, secular nature of the state. So the people, the young people, girls and boys who wanted to get an education in universities weren't allowed. In some cases, they weren't allowed health services because they had an ID card with a headscarf photo on. So all this was done within a systematic, especially after the coup. There were times we had the headscarf ban in universities and at other public institutions that were applied on and off after the 1980 military coup as well. But the 28 February coup was based on the fact that there were people who insisted that they wanted to exist in the Turkish society with their own values. And unfortunately, it included people who were business mm-hmm. people because they were conservative. They weren't allowed to practice their business. They had a lot of obstacles in front of them. But it was a systematic form of discrimination, especially towards the women, because it was so visible. If they wore the headscarf.
You know, it's very interesting for anybody who's been to Turkey, for foreigners, those of us who are foreigners who live and work here. It's now a country where religion is so openly practiced. You see women wearing their headscarves. It's not something that is not allowed. But it's interesting that when the new administration came into power in 2002, I believe, it allowed women to wear headscarves, but it was only allowed in public institutions from 2013. Why did it take so long, though, for that to happen?
Yes, because that ideology stood. This wasn't something that happened in one day. It was over the decades. So the people, the women who wear the headscarf being the most visible symbol, it was the people who wanted to practice their religion. They were perceived as a terrorist threat. So it's interesting. It took AK Party a while of democratization and a societal consensus. Now, when we talk about it, it seems so funny, ridiculous, but it's tragic at the same time that it took so long. There was previously in 2007, 2008, attempts to ban the ban on the headscarf. But the Republican Party, our main opposition party, took it to the Constitutional Court and got that lift of the ban revoked. So it took us a long time. Like you said, in 2013, the lift in the universities, which was unconstitutional, by the way, was the ban, the lift of the headscarf ban was in 2013. And in the Grand National Assembly of Turkey, Turkey being one of the countries where women had the right to vote and get represented to run for office in 1934. However, the headscarfed women only had that right, me being one of them. We earned that our right to get elected in 2015, which is an embarrassment.
I'm afraid we're going to have to leave it there. But Ravza Kavcıkan, great talking to you. Thank you so much for your time.